Hi everybody. Heist weekend backbreaker. Well, first of all, I feel like I gotta address this what's going on in Germany right now. It's well, there's not much to say. Obviously, it's fucking tragic, and I don't think there's much else we can do except hope for the best. Hope the German police or military or whatever forces get a hold of this soon and catch whatever guy or guys or people are doing this. Sadly, because I'm kind of used to stuff like this where I'm from, I personally believe that the only thing we can do right now is just, well, nothing really, is just hope for the best, stay indoors, hope for everyone we care and know about to be okay, and hope for them to catch everything. And I'm gonna try and not belittle that, but try and take your minds off that, because we won't. Like, again, from experience, there's no point in just tripping over that stuff, especially this early. Like, no information right now can be no information right now can be counted upon. Stuff changes all the time. It's only gonna be like a couple more hours from now, I guess, until we get solid information, until which probably won't be until this event is over. So that's what I got to say about that. So for now, I'm gonna try and take your minds off of that. But yeah, I just felt like I gotta address that, Weru. So I'm gonna try and take your minds off that with some more Danganronpa. We were just getting where things get interesting, I think. Monokuma arrived. We finally got some. We finally got some. We know the rules, the stuff. The true game actually began. And now, well, the last thing that happened is that Byakuya gathered everyone together. Said he got some stuff. It does seem like his character changed from last game, even though he doesn't remember apparently what happened in the last game. At least that's what I think. Last game he started by being all on his own and not wanting to help anyone but himself, and this time it seems like right from the beginning he's starting to want to work with people. So, and he asked us to all go to the Jabberwock Park for him to show us some stuff. Also, my little pet is about to my little Pokemon Go right here is about to evolve. In 46 steps, so we'll see what happens then. Anyhow, what are you doing? You should head over to the park. Kind of pick up their voices. Fuck this fucking screen.
What? Didn't the same thing happen last time too?
Hey!
Hajime, how many times are you gonna surprise me? I just spoke to you normally. Anyway, you should hurry over to the park.
Damn it!
Shut up! I'm going back to my room! Seriously, this is all just one big hassle.
Well, guess who's gonna be the first one to die?
Arr, damn it! Seriously, if we're on a tropical paradise, then why are we in this situation in the first place? Isn't that right? Isn't a vacation supposed to be nothing but lounging around and sipping coconut juice? Relax. Snapping at me won't change a thing, okay?
Hey!
Hajime, it's decided. You better come to the beach with me later. Huh? For coconuts, damn it! I saw some big ones that fell onto the shore. Haven't figured out how to split them open, but once I do, we're gonna have ourselves some coconut juice.
You can't just will a coconut open. Just give up and get some coconut juice from the supermarket.
You just don't understand. Fine, be that way. I'm never gonna ask for your help again.
Okay, so either he's gonna die or he's gonna be framed in a murder. One or the other.
He left. I hope he goes straight to the park. Now then, I should hurry too.
Okie doke. Is quickest to the park? I think it's to the left from here. I think. It's kind of hard to tell with this, actually. And I leveled up. And any moment now. Oh, there we go. What do we get?
snake. A snake-emi. Snake-emi? I don't know. It's kind of cute, though. It's a sneaky snake.
In all these games, some of the most dislikable characters never die. Well, yeah, actually, that's true. Last game was sort of like that. Let's see, who were the survivors? The only guy I really didn't like who survived was, the fortune teller, who was really annoying towards the end, and a bunch of characters I liked died. Yeah, come to think of it, I think most of the characters I didn't like survived last time, so... But we'll see, but there are a lot of characters I don't really like that much this time, so we'll see, how does it go? Yeah, exactly, the dumbass speaker. Should have died. Showed that a bunch of times. He got super lucky. And there are a bunch of characters here who really want to die. So we'll see. I really want to know who's the first one to die. I was hoping for someone to die already in the prologue, like in the first game, but no such luck. At least you can say they're not rehashing it. Okay. So again, we need to walk the center of the island. I'm not sure how to reach, like, which... Last time I walked from the, like, to the right, and it took forever. So I'm gonna try going to the left now. Need to remember to clean after the pet, too. There we go. Okay, yeah. Kind of want to save and see what happens if I approach that thing. Probably nothing, because I don't think I can actually die in this game. What's the...
That strange mono beast machine is blocking the bridge. I shouldn't carelessly approach it.
Okay. Oh yeah, that thing is kind of scary. Actually, kind of reminds of the dog from Revengeance, doesn't it? With the tail and the gun on his back. Wonder if there's a connection. Sneaky snake. Kinda like my snake. There we go. We're almost up another level. Oh, we also need to be on the lookout for... Oh shit, what the fuck is that? There's too much magic in this game. Anyway, we need to be on the lookout for Monokuma plushies, so... If you see them, let me know. For skinny people, you're awfully slow.
Seems you are just too fast for us.
The ones you wanted the guy to die when the game started were the Foulmouth Loli, the Dumbass Mechanic, and the Gundam Tanaka. Yeah, I want the cook to die, I want the Loli to die, I like the mechanic though. And I'm not sure what you mean by Gundam Tanaka. You mean the team leader? I like him actually.
Jeez, I never expected a fatso like him to move so fast.
What?
So, what's supposed to be here?
What? Well,
can't you see it? Here? Really?
Such ignorance.
If you haven't noticed it yet, then I was right to dismiss you all as idiots. Yeah, probably that. Let's look around a bit though, see if we can see any... plushies? There's a wreckage of the battle. Yeah, where, I can't believe they didn't, like, check, Umami or Usami's body. Like, that's supposed to be super important. But where, maybe there was just nothing left of her. Anyhow, they're probably talking about the timer. Oh, the breeder? Nah, I kinda like the breeder too. Again, I like to do his voice and I kinda like his hamsters. I wanna see what they're gonna do with him.
What is that?
Oh, no. Oh, so that's the motivation this time? If someone doesn't kill someone else, we all die? That's kind of stupid.
An obviously out of place object placed in the center of a peaceful park. It looks like a clock, but something seems off. It's counting down! How can you tell?
What's going on?
Was this here when we came last time?
No! No, brother! I'm pretty sure it wasn't!
I found it this morning when I was exploring the island one more time. It's unknown when it was actually placed here.
It appears
Monokuma must have placed this object. What does this countdown even mean?
I have no clue!
Once again, something has appeared that I don't understand. But it's got nothing to do with me, because I refuse to believe this is happening.
Hold on!
Could it be? It better not be a bomb, brother!
Are you kidding me?
A bomb?
Here we got the new Shaggy.
Not possible.
If they wanted to blow up the island, they would have done so by now. There's no need for a countdown.
Then, what are they counting down?
It's a mystery.
Right?
A mysterious mystery, isn't it?
Yeah!
Monomi?
What?
Why are you here?
I heard everyone talking while I was patrolling, so I came over.
No, not that. Didn't Monokuma kill you?
I see.
Ah, so that's why you were surprised. You won't have to worry about that. After all, I can never die.
It appears you cannot escape.
I see. You must be an undead abomination, risen from the foulest depths of the netherworld by black magic.
Do you want me to make you my thrall?
Monomi's a mechanical stuffed animal, right? Doesn't that mean she can't die in the first place?
Now that you mention it, she'd only need, like, a spare or something. Yeah, she probably has a bunch of them, like Monokuma.
A spare? What a mean thing to say!
However, you have arrived at the perfect time. There's something I wanted to ask you.
Come on.
What is the meaning behind this timer and this countdown? Answer me.
Countdown? What is this? I'm sorry. I don't know what this is.
Hey. You really don't know?
Did someone die already? No, actually, that's someone came to life. As you can see.
I don't really have a grasp of what Monokuma is up to.
Huh?
You don't know? Even your Monokuma's little sister?
That's wrong!
I'm not my brother's little sister!
Did she accept the role or not? Which one is it?
Alrighty!
Anyway, let's all do our best! Let's kick the evil Monokuma off this island!
If you don't know what the countdown is for, you're useless to us. Get lost.
Let's... together!
I said get lost.
Yeah.
I'm sorry!
Perhaps you are being a little too harsh. I am starting to feel sorry for it.
Miss Sonia! May I call you Miss Sonia? No, I insist on calling you that.
I won't be fooled.
There's no need to feel sorry for that thing. She's obviously working with Monokuma.
Hey, bastard.
Who the fuck cares about that stuffed animal? More importantly, what the hell is that clock?
Looks ominous, doesn't it? Who put that object here? How did they do it in just one night?
I can't imagine.
Which means it doesn't make any sense. Also, it's deadly. However, that's not all that's unimaginable. This island is full of mysteries that we can't begin to imagine. For example, how were the 16 of us brought to this island again? Thank God Byakuya is the smart one. Like, thank God we got him from the last game, because last game he was the second smartest one, and I forgot her name, but the waifu was the smartest one. Since we don't have hers, thank God we at least have him. Well, yeah, this little shit, he was also on the list of people who wanted to die in the first game. Oh, the Yakuza. Yeah, definitely want him to die. Can't wait. He definitely will, too.
Can't wait for him to die. I think he's gonna be this game's Chihiro. We're gonna find out that he's a girl. It's gonna be a reverse trap, because he does look like a girl. It's pretty obvious why a girl would wanna, a Yakuza girl would wanna fake being a boy. So anyway, hold on. Okay. Anyway, yeah. Hey, Lieutenant. I wasn't trying to think about that since it's been bugging me too, but he's right. That is a mystery. Well, Byakuya is the most useful guy so far because he's just the smartest. He's the only one who's actually trying to think about what's going on. Except a bit like our character, but Togami's on a whole other level. There's more. Why is Jabberwock Island, which was known for being a popular resort destination, now an uninhabited island because of the apocalypse? Obviously, forgot about that. Assuming again this is in the future. This is after the first game and not before. There's no sign of tourists or even citizens on this island. Is something like that even possible?
This too must be the
All civilizations are destined to collapse. Nothing begets existence, and existence begets nothing.
So it collapsed?
You are right.
Society is much like fruit. Once it matures, it is inevitable that it will eventually rot. As the economy grows, the private sector stagnates as elders and bureaucrats become more and more powerful. As time passes, this power becomes the status quo and crushes the seeds of any possible reformation.
That is...
such a sad trend.
I don't really understand all that, but I feel like the situation here is somewhat different.
So...
maybe the Mono Beast killed everyone on this island?
What? And that's how it became uninhabited, brother!
It's certainly possible.
That's a possibility, but we don't know that for sure. This mystery remains a mystery, it seems. Oh, I also want her to die, the emo bitch.
Grr, it's like... rawr. It's like everything here is just full of mysteries!
You're right. It's mysteries on top of mysteries. She's not really emo, Morcine. Same thing in my book, Wada. However, since these mysteries are overlapping with one another, I doubt some no-name group is behind this.
What are you trying to say?
So, in other words...
I mean, the situation we're in is undeniably the work of some enormous organization. Yeah, I don't think we ever knew how she got the resources. The girl who controlled Monokuma in the first game. I don't think we ever learned that, so... like, who backed her, basically. Except that maybe she was rich? I don't remember, really. I think maybe she was rich.
Enormous organization?
And yeah, the hamsters are tight. I like the hamsters. Of, Gundam. Monomi, Monokuma, the Mono Beasts, they're all machines that require major technical skill to operate.
Are we screwed?
Plus, they need a ton of funding, and there's no way those things were made just for the hell of it.
In other words...
that organization might be controlling these machines and monitoring the island with those cameras.
Then...
could those fiends be hiding on this island?
Not possible.
Not likely. They're probably running this from somewhere else, somewhere safe.
Oh? Where would that be, brother?
I don't know. Anyway, there's no mistake that an enormous organization is behind all this.
I see. A big organization, huh? I can't imagine what kind of people they could be.
In other words...
well, let's see. There's my Togami Corporation, Sonia's Novosella Kingdom, and the Kuzuryu Clan. It would definitely have to be an organization as powerful as one of those groups, if not more so.
I'm used to being mistrusted. Do what you will.
Hey!
Hold on! I don't care about you or the Kuzuryu clan, but I won't allow you to doubt Miss Sonia.
Oh, fuck you.
Miss Sonia is a hot blonde princess. There's a sharp distinction between her and you punks.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, yeah. Just shut up already, loser.
Whoa!
Well, loser? Are you talking about me?
You.
It's obvious from your flashy clothes that you just want to stand out because you're actually a loser.
Look who's talking, bitch.
It must be hard to make your living in the lame-ass loser industry.
Bitch, are you serious right now?
Too far, dude. That's going too far.
Hey, Byakuya, were you serious just now? About this being related to your family and Sonia's and such?
I'm just using them as an example. I'm not saying they have anything to do with this.
But you're certain that we're up against a huge organization, right? Even if such an organization exists, why would they make us go through something like this? Whatever. How long are we gonna keep talking about this? Why don't we talk about something more realistic?
Our enemy's purpose is still unknown. As long as we find out who's behind this, we'll learn their purpose.
So in other words...
So what we must do now is find out who our enemy is. If we do that, we'll be that much closer to a breakthrough. Luckily, according to the e-handbook, we are free to explore this island.
Listen.
There will definitely be a clue about the enemy on this island somewhere. Let's start looking.
I'm gonna do it!
Alright, let's get this crap done!
What are we looking for?
Hey!
Akane, were you even listening? We need to find clues that will tell us who our enemy is.
Fine.
No problem. No matter how large this organization may be, they will not be able to stand against us.
Go by four dark devas of destruction!
Devas?
They are destined to fall and turn to ash at the might of my four dark devas of destruction.
Wow.
Hamsters came out of your scar. Hehe, they are so adorable.
What?
Adorable? You say?
Thank you.
Oh my!
You're pretty happy about that, huh?
Look at that guy talking to Miss Sonia all casually. I'm definitely gonna beat the crap out of him later.
I don't get it. In this tense situation, we all need to be a lot more cautious. And yet, I'm relieved everyone is in such high spirits. It's strange, but I feel like I can rely on them.
Okay. Oh yeah, don't spoil shit for me, please. You can put in spoilers, I'm not opening them. It's all cool, Sweetcount, and I'm not opening any spoilers that have to do with the plot. Like if we see someone talking about anything to do with the game.
This must be what it means to have the confidence of an ultimate. Then, what am I?
Ah, Backcountry, you fucking ruined it, come on! I didn't know someone was gonna die! Well, I might as well just not play this game at all now. If someone's gonna fucking die, I like all of these guys. I don't want anyone here to die, at all.
Am I confident enough to call myself one of them? Damn it, I still can't remember. What talent am I supposed to have?
Listen.
Anyway, let me just say this. There's no time to think about something as foolish as killing each other. You must do what you have to do. Observe, speculate, recognize, comprehend. Even if it seems impossible, just persevere. But most importantly, follow my lead. I'll make sure to return you all to your normal lives.
This is your leader's order.
Understand?
That's like totally awesome! That right hand is so plump! I've got the perfect nickname for him! Ham Hands!
Ham Hands?
You say?
Interesting.
I never thought I'd see the day when someone called me something like that.
Huh? Why aren't you getting mad?
Naturally.
Why would I get mad at something as petty as that? She observed me directly and thought up a nickname. There's nothing dishonest about a name like that. Perhaps. I've always yearned for this, though it may seem ironic for me to realize that in this particular situation.
He's totally monologuing right now.
Such silly talk.
Don't worry about it. I was talking to myself just now. It does seem like just from Byakuya's attitude that it is after the first game somehow. I don't know how he got fat in a post-apocalyptic environment, but somehow he did. And it does seem like he has a character more, like his personality is more similar to the one he had at the end of the first game than the beginning of the second game.
I see. I don't really get it, but I guess this guy isn't just some overconfident narcissistic jerk after all. Despite her situation, he's mysteriously calm. He might just be a reliable person after all.
Alright!
Alright.
Oh, this guy I hate the most. This guy I want to die first, please. I'll probably stay until the end, but I really want him to die. It's also super obvious that he's a traitor. Or that he knows more than he lets on.
Alright then. We should listen to Byakuya and not waste our energy thinking about pointless things. It's not that we're not in the best situation, but it's also not the worst.
Great!
Because we're not alone. We have friends we can count on to support each other. Oh, fuck
Miles.
You. Seriously? That sounds so lame. I knew it. I was thinking to myself just how lame I sounded for saying that.
Oh my god, I hate you.
Friends, huh? Until now, I never really thought about friendship. That sort of thing seemed embarrassing. I never would have thought about it in this situation. No, actually, it's more like because of this situation. In the end, we never solved the mystery of the ominous countdown. But without losing heart, we all went back to the hotel. Believe in your friends, huh? It'd be difficult to believe in them right away, but it'd be nice if it could happen a little at a time. Huh. If I'm starting to think like that, doesn't that show I'm making good progress?
Whatever. Anyhow, you see that little thing up on the red shelf? That's what we need to look for everywhere. Little Monokuma dolls or whatever.
Now then, there's no reason to hole up in my room and stare blankly into space. Since there's time, it'd be a great idea if I went ahead and talked to everyone.
One of these things. Okay, I know it's sudden, but it's time for a brief tutorial. During the school trip, there will be moments called free time. During free time, you'll be able to strengthen your friendship by spending time with the other students. Also, if you give them a present afterwards, you might make an even better impression. You can obtain presents from the Mono Yashin, okay, and the vending machine at the supermarket. When you strengthen a friendship, an intimate event is activated and added to the report card. Also, if you show any hope fragments you've gathered to Usami via the report card, you can gain new skills. Feel free to strengthen your friendships with as many people as you want. Also, when you spend time with someone, time will pass, and it will return to your cottage afterwards. After passing the time several times, the free time will end and you will continue on to the main story. By the way, you can skip free time by resting in your cottage bed. Although I don't really recommend it, please use it if you want to just continue the main story right away. Well, we won't do that because we'll get fucked, but... Yeah, people told me to only use the one on the beach. So I think we're going to go, first of all, to the... First of all, I'm going to save and check on my pet. Snake. So I'm going to save. I want to check a couple of stuff. I do want to look for the Monokuma stuff, so maybe we'll do that first, and then we'll do the free time. I'm going to post a poll, Lieutenant. As soon as I'm done looking for Monokuma dolls, I'm going to do just that. And also, I want to check if I can already get some skills through here. Please select the skill you want. Can I get info on them?
Any recommendations here? Well, just save. So let's see. Let's just choose one and see what I can do. Oh, there we go. Okay, so that lets me know. Okay, let's look at some stuff. That's the first one. Let's see what we got. Okay, attentive influence. Slightly increases the influence gauge. Effective during a class trial. Cannot be combined with envious influence. Slightly increases the focus gauge. Effective during class trial. Yeah, I remember that. Doesn't really help me. Slightly increases the time limit for each phase. Effective during the class trial. Increases influence gauge. Recovery when correct answers are chosen. Effective when making. This might be good. Charisma. Composed athlete steadies your aim, effective during the non-stop debate. Reduces your aiming speed, effective during the non-stop debate. I don't really need that, I think. Increases your aiming speed, don't really need that. Trigger happy. Increases delay between firing truth bullets, I don't really think I need that. Algorithm, increases the speed of memorizing a statement. Speed of memorizing a statement? That sounds pretty useful. I think I'll go with algorithm and charisma so far. Focus gauge decreases the slower rate during concentration and fever time, like during non-stop debate, blah blah. Delusion, the influence gauge recovers over time during concentration and fever time, like during blah blah blah. Melodious voice, increases damage to an opponent when the statement is destroyed. Vocabulary increases bullet capacity. I would want a lesser bullet capacity, wait a minute. Ambidextrousness allows you to lock on two statements at once, effective during. Why would I want that though? As long as it goes the same as the last game. Easier to shift mood to your favor. This sounds like it'd be real good too, mood maker. Sharpness increases by 2, I don't know what that is. Increased by 5, well obviously I'm gonna want this. Clock up increases max speed. Turning power, I don't know what that is. Jumping power, I don't know what these are. We're pretty low. Let's see, slightly increase the influence gauge. I think I'm back at the beginning. Yeah. Okay, so let's see. I wanted charisma. I wanted algorithm. And I wanted mood maker, I think. Which one do I want most though? Easier to shift in your frame. That's a bit vague, but I think that's good in this case. Algorithm increases the speed of memorizing a statement. Also sounds good. And charisma increases the influence gauge recovering when. Okay, I think I'll go with algorithm. And the other one. What was it? Woodmaker. Okay, hopefully it's good. And I'm gonna wait for the rest for now. Okay, now that we did that, let's go and look for some Monokuma dolls, and then we'll buy some shit, and then we'll talk to people. That's the order. Okay, I might as well just walk around. Gain some levels, work on my pet, get it to level up even more if I can. Wonder how many levels though, or forms the pet actually has. Which there are 5 dolls in total on each island. Okay, thanks. That actually really helps. So I need. Already found one, so I need to find 2 more. Nothing here it seems. I mean, the first one was really easy to spot. So I think that if I just don't see anything here, it should be okay. Okay. All right, I forgot about the run. Thanks, Lieutenant. How are we already here? Just talk through here? Okay. dolls aren't targeted when you look for. Okay. Oh, there's one. Well, that was easy. Again. I think. Maybe that's nothing. It's for the monkey, though. You can try your hand against the almighty modem. Oh, that's the machine? No, I'm gonna do it later. But I'd like to learn more about it. During your stay here at Jabberwock Island, you'll find coins scattered throughout the island. These mono coins are treasured, blah blah. You can use the handbook menu to see how many you got. If you put the coins in this machine here, there's a chance you could win a prize. The more coins you use, the better chance you have. Oh, so it's basically the same as the last game. Check the presents. I'll do it later when I got more coins. Anyway, what's the deal with this? Like, can't I choose this? It looks like a Monokuma thing. That's a machine. No, come on. Oh, that's the little machine. Oh, I thought the machine is like the stuff. Is like the monkey and the stuff above. Okay, I get it now. Well, let's look around. I don't see shit around here, to be honest. The dolls or the whole Monokuma body. Okay. Well, don't see them here either. Well, whatever. Let's keep going, I guess. Okay, keep going. I'm gonna assume there are no dolls over here. Just because I can't target anything here, I can just run left and right. Yeah, our little pet evolved into a sneaky snake. Okay, here there's gotta be something. It's just too big of an area to pass up. I think, there we go. Too easy.
I knew you could do it.
Nice. 10 monocoins. Okay, well, that one was easy. I'm gonna assume there's not a second one around here. Also, does the Jabberwock Park count as an island? Like, there are also five dolls there? Yeah, yeah, Lieutenant. I'm playing with the English voice because I'm doing voices, so it would be harder for me to copy voices if they're in Japanese. So I'm forced to do the English dub. Okay, let's check the market. I mean, logically, there should be one in each area, I think, if there are five in total. Let's look around here. Nothing around there. Missed it. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I see it now. I was looking at other spots.
Serious?
I didn't think it would be right in front of me. But okay, that's how I learned like the way it goes. Okay, so it can't be right in front of me. I'm gonna assume, I thought it would be like over here, hitting around these because it's classic, but I was wrong. It doesn't seem like there's another one around here. That. Pooped yet? No. Pretty soon, probably. We're back here. Oh, right! There are a bunch of areas in the hotel. Forgot about that. Okay. Now, again, I looked a bit around here earlier and didn't see any dolls, so I don't think in this area there are any, but maybe like in the restaurant and the reception, shit like that. So we found three in total, right? We need to find only two.
You can't!
Oh, because she's alive again, so we can't go inside? Okay. No step on snake. Oh, speaking of which, she probably pooped already. No. That was a very patient snake. One of the dolls is in that building. Well, I'm just gonna look around in these two areas and then I'm gonna throw the pole and go to buy some shit. Yeah, I don't see it. Again, assuming I really can't get the other two until I advance. I don't see it hiding here behind anything. Try and go downstairs. Oh, she's here playing the arcade games. And I don't see him here either. Okay, so I guess we'll just wait until later on in the story to get those. And I didn't notice if you guys answered earlier if Jabberwock Park also counts as an island. Like, if I should look over there also for one of the dolls. Okay, well. It's not a lot of coins, but it's something. It's not? Okay. And it's really small too. Yeah, but I thought maybe it's like, it counts as this one or something. Okay, so it won't take too long, I'm gonna make the poll right now. And you guys can vote while I get the presents. So for now, what I want to do? Yeah, strong pull. Because we got 15 fucking characters, it might take a while, but I like it when you guys choose. Okay, I'm gonna write them by ultimates because I think it's easier to remember than than by names. So that's us. We got Lucky. We got Byakuya, fat guy. I think that's easier to remember him by. Reader. Whoops. Hold on. We got Mechanic. We got Cook, who's also a horn dog. We got Team Manager, who's the big guy. We got Yakuza, who's a girl. We got Gymnast. She's got huge boobs for like a gymnast, you know? Girdle Gamer. We got Princess. We got Lolly Dancer. We got, who else? God, that's a lot. Photographer. We got Nurse. Who's a whiny bitch. We got Musician. And we got Swordsman. Okay. So you guys can vote now. Who am I gonna talk to? And I'm gonna get some shit. So I'm gonna get some presents for now. And then we'll find where they are and we'll give them some presents or give Snack some presents. Pet real quick. Did a poop. Nice. No step on snake. And we want to go to the beach, which I think is over here. Or maybe not. No, it's actually the wrong way. I think to the right is the... Don't give the snake any presents? Why? But I want the snake to be full of hope. So I'll get the best Best character, best pet. Aww. I wanted the best pet. God damn it. When's the kid cup? But he didn't have the chance, he couldn't buy shit. Well, that's this fucking game, come on. That's just ultra gay. Fine, whatever. Before it enters the cocoon? Well, why didn't the game say so? And why didn't the game tell me, like, okay, so don't run, don't go everywhere by foot right now, because if you do that, you'll definitely, like, the pet will definitely evolve. I didn't go anywhere that I wasn't supposed to go. I just followed the story, and I just walked everywhere like the game told me I should. That's annoying. I wanted the best pet. Fuck it. Let's just go the mono fucking machine. Give it a shot. Because it's Japanese difficulty. It's not even difficulty, it's just like not explaining, they're explaining like the wrong things about the game. But whatever. Alright, let's give it a shot. List. Okay. Let's start with... What? What's going on with these? Well, I think last game I did, like, as long as the repeat rate was under 15, I was good. Hold on. Okay, I'm waiting. What's up, Wada? Yeah, exactly, Suika. You get it. They keep explaining the plot a million times, but they don't actually say anything about, but the stuff that needs explaining, they don't. The best strat all the time is to use one coin. Well, yeah, that's what I did last game. I just used one coin until I got to like 15 or 20% repeat rate, and then I went 2, and then again until it's 15, and then I went 3. Oh, even while I have like 90 plus percent? Okay. I trust you, Wada. Even though you didn't tell me about the pet, but I still trust you. Let's see what I get. I got, I don't know, what is that, a rock or something? And a bag. We'll see what we got later. Let's try and speed this through. Earrings, I guess. I wish I could speed this up. A pen. Oops. Was that a crossbow or a fishing hook or something? Music's decent. You're right, it is faster than the first game, Lupin. They did improve some aspects of the game from the first one, but not all of them. Or not as many as I had hoped. A doll or something? A vacuum cleaner? Or a VR helmet? I'm not sure what that was. What was it called? Okay, that's probably for the swordswoman. Yeah, people did tell me... Ooh, it's a swordy thing? People did tell me that the cases are much harder and much cooler this game. So we'll see. They improved a lot of stuff except for the writing. Yep, well, we'll see. Oh, another skull. Clattering teeth? I don't know what that was. A mouth gag? That's probably for the cook. I don't know, journal? Book? Love something? Some angel dust? Some drugs? some more tuna. And nice leather boots. Okay, so we're done. We should probably get going. So, let's see who you guys chose. And, oh wow, only two guys votes. Only two guys voted. It's a tie between Fat Guy and Girl Gamer. And if that's the case, I'm gonna be the tiebreaker and I choose the Yakuya. I like him way better. Okay, so let's see where he is exactly. Yakuya, where are you? He's probably on the island. Yeah, I love him like I thought. But Yakuya has a spoiler. Okay. So, let's head out. Leave here. Go to the central island. Oh, we also need to check out what Byakuya likes and what he doesn't. Likes food, probably. Likes coffee, dislikes commoners. I'm not sure if I got coffee. Let's see what I do have. If anyone wants to do the same like the previous game and just Google like what presents he likes the most, we could just do that. Got non-alcoholic white or risotto, whatever that is. Sweets bun bag. Sweetbreads, he might like this. Potato chips, well we got lots of food, that's good. Salt. Do we have coffee? Frey jean pants. Secret boots. Earring of crushed evil. Oops, peak ring. Cloth wrap backpack. What does it have in it? Nothing. Kiss note. Mr. Stapler. Is that a Office Space joke? I don't think so. American Clacker, whatever that is. Toy camera. Power gauntlet. Gag ball. Oh, that is a gag ball. A dynamo. Ghost stone. Collapse symbol. Fishing rod. Seven sword. Memory notebook. Broken warhead. Dip pen. Rose in vitro. Skull head mask. Replica sword. Crystal ball. And that's it. Do we have any of those? Well, yeah, Suika, but Hotel Dusk, I like the way they did it. They did it at least in a clever manner. It didn't feel like just repeating. It felt like Kyle really needed to like gather his thoughts for a moment. And was much quicker and less annoying than the way they do it here. Anyway, mineral water, Ramune, Blue Ram, Century Potpourri, Chocolate Chip Jerky, Sweet Bun Bag, we got that. Razor Ramon HG, Hope Speak Ring, we got that too. Gojobo Dolls, and Rose and Vitro. We got a bunch of them. That's great. Oh, Togami likes number 9, 13, 17, and 45. What were those? 9, 13, 17, and 45. Don't have it. We got 13. Don't have 17. And what was that? 39? Well, anyway, we got the bun bag, so we might as well just use that. Cool. Over here, I think. Non-alcoholic wine? Well, I don't know. I guess it's kind of like root beer? I don't know. Okay, finally, we're gonna talk to Byakuya. Yeah, no Monokuma's here, it seems. Let's do this.
What?
What happened? Are you also searching for the enemy's clues?
What should I do? Should I invite Byakko to hang out?
Yeah, let's hang out, dude. So you want to search together? Very well, but try not to slow me down. I spent time with Byakko today searching for the enemy's clues.
Looks like Byakko let me get a little closer to him.
Like to give him a present? Definitely. What do I want to give him? The bun bag, or whatever that was. The sweet bun bag. Filled with a variety of sweetbreads, including melon and peanut butter flavors, the bag has a logo of Hansel and Gretel. Whatever. Let's try this.
What did you say?
Where did you obtain this? This masterpiece couldn't even be found by the collective effort of my Togami Corporation. Are you serious, dude? It's a fucking food bag. I'll be keeping this. Hey, Hajime, let me ask you one thing.
Huh? Me? I don't really mind, but...
There's something I've been wondering for quite a while, and I'd like to purge that question from my mind.
Listen.
So let me ask you, what is your body fat percentage?
Huh? Well, I don't really know the exact number. I've never had it checked before.
What?
Never had it checked before?
This can't be!
Are you saying you have no intention of understanding the ratio of fat stored within you? I swear, this is why I dislike commoners.
For some reason, Byakko's mood seems abnormal. I was trying to think I've actually done something wrong.
I see.
However, just by looking at you, I'd say that you're a 9. No, maybe an 8. Regardless, it's probably around one digit. Be grateful this is a tropical island. If you were somewhere less hospitable, you'd freeze to death. You think maybe the reason he became fat is, like, strategical? I wonder.
I see.
Anyway, you still can't remember what your talent is?
Yeah, not yet.
Don't worry.
I see. However, there's no need for you to be depressed over it.
Huh?
What's with that face?
Nothing. I just thought I was going to get yelled at again.
How foolish. Do you really think I'd get mad about something like that? A person like me has a responsibility to watch over you, weaklings. Besides, as long as I'm here, it doesn't matter what your talent is.
In the name of my family.
As long as Byakko Togami's in charge, you will all know peace. It feels like he's gonna die soon, and I really don't want that.
I see. His personality is so overwhelming.
The Togami Corporation is famous worldwide, but it will grow even more rapidly under my command. You should feel lucky that someone isn't as talented as me is here.
Listen.
Just believe in me. If you do, everything will turn out fine.
I don't really understand, but he's extremely confident. So this is Byakko Togami, the ultimate affluent progeny.
Just make sure you don't get in my way. A commoner should know their place and stay put. Actually, yeah, I guess Byakko is really my waifu so far.
Goodbye.
However, if there is anything troubling you, I don't mind if you rely on me.
After saying that, Byakko gallantly strolled away. He was being pretty condescending, but he doesn't seem like a bad guy. I feel like I got to know a little bit about Byakko.
Report card, and I got a hope fragment, and I leveled up. Excellent. Okay, I decide to return to my room for now.
It's still bright out, and I've still got some time left. I don't feel like doing nothing, so maybe I should go somewhere.
More free time. Okay, let's do that poll another time. Okay, let's do that poll again, and we'll see what we get now. Too bad it doesn't remember what the options I put in. Okay, let's do this again. So we got Lucky, we got Fatso, we got Edgelord, we got Mechanic, we got Hentai, we got Big Guy, we got Yakuza, fuck her, we got, or rather, Reverse Trap, we got Gymnast, we got Girl Gamer, we got Princess, we got Lolly Stripper, I mean, come on, we got Photographer, we got Nurse, we got Scene Girl, no, rather, hold on, I got something for this. Okay, and we got Swords Woman. Okay, I think that's it. Let's create the poll. Thank God, finally. Okay, I'm gonna give you guys some time to choose. So I got two of his. What else did I want? Can't get neutral liberation. Where are the... What's this? I wanna know. Focus gauge decreases at a slower rate during concentration and fever time. Effectiveness during... Don't really know yet. I feel like I need more... I think I'm gonna wait until the first trial to see exactly what other skills I wanna get. And I better save while I got the time. Check my pet, save. Sneak. And okay, let's see where everybody is for now. Okay, so Byakuya is here this time. We got, I don't know who that is over here. We got the big guy in there as well. We got, actually I don't remember their names at all. Well, the Edgelord, no, that's not the Edgelord. Oh, whatever. Airport. Doesn't really matter, I'm just like waiting until you guys are done with the poll. I think I'm gonna look right now, actually. That should be enough time for everyone wanting to vote. Okay, it seems like we got another tie, a three-way tie. We got the musician, we got the perv, and we got the Akian again. And again, out of the three, again, if I'm gonna be the tiebreaker, then I choose Byakuya. He's the most interesting one to me so far. And he's my waifu, so you know. Oh, I can also run here, that's cool. There he is. I'll check, I'm gonna refresh one more time. And yeah, three votes. Okay, three-way tie. Here we go. Oh, actually, oh, I got another one of those pack lunches he likes so much. So where's that?
Very strange.
Why did the organization behind this matter kidnap us? Waifu for Laifu, that's right. I'd like to think about it, but there just aren't enough clues. What should I do? Yeah, let's hang out, dude. Very well. I was just starting to get hungry from overthinking.
This is your leader's order.
Let's eat something light. Follow me. Spent time with Ryaku today watching him eat and an obscene amount of food. Looks like Becker let me get a little closer to him. Give him a present. Let's do the same thing as last time. Number, what was it? 13. What? Oh, it doesn't do the same effect the same time I give it to him? Oh, man. Oh, just thinking that I wanted this. Are you stalking me or something? I guess I'll say thank you, but stalking is never acceptable behavior. The chicken in my hands is far tastier than the beef inside the freezer.
What?
Anyway, well, at least now I know, I guess, that I shouldn't give him like the same gift over and over. Which sucks, but whatever. It's a German proverb. It means something inferior that's nearby is better than something good that's far away. But why would chicken be inferior to beef? Aren't there times when you obviously want to eat fried chicken instead of steak? Oh, same gift is fine? Oh, well, if you say so.
That's true, but what are we even talking about? I mean, is that even a real German proverb?
What are you thinking?
Is it proverb or proverb? And furthermore, why is pork not even mentioned in this comparison? Is pig meat unattractive to Germans?
Why?
Well, it's haram, and Germany is, New Algeria, or New Turkey, so... No, that's impossible. When you think of Germany, you think of sausage. If you think of sausage, you're thinking of pig meat.
That's...
What does this mean? What is this conspiracy? Proverb?
What in the world is he so worked up about?
Hajime, do you know which meat is the most efficient source of energy?
Listen.
What meat contains the most vitamin B1 for converting glucose to energy? What?
Yaku is so serious, it's scaring me. I have no idea, what should I answer?
I don't know, I'm gonna try and Google that maybe? Unless someone here knows? What meat has the most B1 vitamin? Top 10 foods high on... Well, it says fish, then pork. So I guess I'm gonna go with pork. Pork is number 2 apparently to the list that came up first on Google, so I'm gonna go with pork.
Is it pork?
Correct. The same amount of pork has 10 times the energy efficiency of other meat. I did not know that. I should eat more pork, if I can. Do you understand? 10 times!
I get it already. What's your point anyway?
Such ignorance.
There's only one thing I want to say to you. Hajime, become my assistant. Oh, my waifu wants me to be his assistant!
Huh?
Listen.
The situation surrounding us in this island is even more complicated than I had thought. Even if it's just a commoner's assistance, it's better than having nobody at all. Well, I don't discriminate between meats. I love pretty much all meats the same. Though I probably like chicken a bit less. No, you know what? I love chicken too. Yeah, I like all meats. I don't discriminate.
But I don't even remember that much about myself. We don't even know if I have a talent that would be useful to you, you know?
Memory. Who cares about that? Yeah, he lost his memory too. Maybe he knows it, maybe he doesn't.
Huh?
So in other words...
Even if you don't have your memories, you're still you, right? You're able to live your own life. Interesting that he says that, considering what we know about him. That is already enough. All you have to do is be yourself. As you stand before me, I will believe in your potential.
Byakuya? Oh...
It means so much to me. Also, what use is the past? I too was powerless in the past, but I'm different now. Oh, maybe he does remember? More than we think? More than he lets on?
throw away your past self. It's meaningless.
Powerless? What's he talking about? Was Byakuya really powerless in the past?
Anyway, think about my offer. More importantly, Hajime.
Listen.
Do you like chicken or beef?
For some reason, I still ended up discussing meat with Byakuya until I had heartburn. Anyway, what happened to Byakuya in the past?
Hope fragment, report card. Didn't level up though. Oh well.
I parted ways with Byakuya and decided to return to my cottage.
Please, can we keep going with the story now? Please? Even though I like spending time with Byakuya. There we go. Do you think somebody will get killed tonight?
Eh? That bell just now. Could it be...
Ahem! Hope's Peak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make! Hello, everyone! The fun time you've all been waiting for is about to begin! I wonder what festivities await you! Oops! Don't want to ruin the surprise! It was a little meh at first, but anyway, please gather at Jabberwock Park!
Oh man.
Did he just tell us to go to the park? It's the middle of the night. What's he up to? I suddenly had a bad feeling about all this, and goosebumps sprung all over my body.
Oh, wait until you hear me do that voice, Wada.
If we're not allowed to defy Monokuma, then there's no way I can ignore this, right? Which means, there's nothing I can do except listen to him. Damn it! What is it now?
Let's go, I guess. Leave, yes. Stuff looks weird, but... whatever. Check on the pep before we go. Snake is good. Kuma has been voiced by Nuboy revealed to be suffering from dementia would be put. Oh, damn! How old was Oyama? Was Nobuyo Oyama that they got dementia? That's usually, like, that usually sits on when someone's really old. Or relatively old, at least. Anyhow, I better save. That's weird, but okay. I mean, on one hand, it's kind of sick that the guy who did Monokuma suffers from dementia. Guy or girl. Is there another cow there? I think there weren't two cows earlier, just one. No way that guy was 82. You're shitting me, Simeon. No way the guy who did Monokuma was 82. Oh, in Japanese maybe. I never actually heard what the Japanese voice of Monokuma sounds like. Maybe it sounds older? And before everyone is being turned into cows. That would be a great plot, I gotta say. She was born 33, holy shit! Well, that really sucks. I never actually heard her voice, but... oh! What are you doing here, Pekko?
Pekko, you came too, huh? I have no choice. After all, the e-handbook clearly states that defying Monokuma is not permitted.
However...
it'd be foolish to resist if it's just going to make things worse. I hope everyone else feels the same way. That worries me a little.
Anyway.
At any rate, we must go to the park. I guess I have no choice, huh?
I guess so. I knew that bats, but I forgot that Robert Bresson was born in 1901.
Everyone was already at Jabberwock Park when I arrived.
Once again, you're late. Did you lose your nerve?
I like to deny that, but he's not exactly wrong either.
That's fine.
Anyway, it seems everyone is here.
How annoying!
Ugh, what is it this time? So friggin' annoying. Then you shouldn't have come.
I mean...
Well, I mean, I don't know what'll happen to me if I don't come. Huh. Since none of us know what'll happen, maybe you should be the one to test that out. Hey, you may talk like you're a tough, wise guy, but you wouldn't be here unless you were scared too.
Huh?
What?
Yeah.
I guess even a big bad Yakuza like you must have been scared of that monster, huh?
You...
What the fuck did you just say?
Wait!
Stop it, you two. Fighting among friends isn't good.
Huh?
What did you just say, friend?
Dumbass!
I'm not your friend, dumbass! And when did I ever become friends with you bastards? Eh? Let me be perfectly clear.
I can do it, you know.
You.
What did you just say?
Is Nagito retarded? No, I'm pretty sure he's a double agent. Nagito.
Oh, you didn't hear me? Then I'll repeat myself just once for you. I said, I can do it. Do it? What are you saying? Don't tell me. Are you being serious right now?
I don't know, timer.
Timer is counting down. Why is it counting down? It isn't counting down, though. I mean, look at it.
Or do they mean the days?
Just looking at this gives me strange goosebumps all over my body.
Well, whatever. Maybe you'll be the first one to die.
Hey, Fuyuhiko, why don't you calm down for a bit?
Bastard!
Don't talk to me like we're friends or something!
Don't misunderstand.
I live in a completely different world than you bastards!
He is so obviously a girl, I mean, come on. Looks like he even puts makeup.
Kill or be killed, that's the kind of world I live in.
Jeez.
The current rules make more sense to me than that play nice and get along crap.
What are you saying?
If you don't stop it right now, I'm going to get seriously angry.
You...
Don't treat me like a kid, bitch!
Just stop.
Just stop already. This kind of fighting will not get us anywhere.
Shut the hell up!
There's no way I'm dealing with this kumbaya crap. If any of you guys want to die, step forward. I'll fucking kill you all right now.
I'm starting to get pumped up!
Sounds fun. Give me your best shot. What's gonna happen if you're this easily provoked?
That's enough.
Enough.
Huh?
I see.
Fuyuhiko, I understand what you're saying.
Don't worry.
I do not intend to dismiss your feelings. There was a time when I also thought the same way as you.
Don't treat me like a fucking
kid. I think he does have
kid.
His memory, maybe, or at least part of it.
Are you treating me like a kid, too?
Let me say this.
But what would reckless killing accomplish? If you fail to get away with it, you know you'll be executed. Or perhaps that's what you really want. If so, you'd only be killing yourself to run away from this predicament. That's what a child would do.
You...
What did you say?
Listen.
Listen. As long as we're here, I will not let any of you die. I will not let any of you become a victim. And that goes for you too, Fuyuhiko. I won't let you die. This seems like really big build-up for Byakuya to die.
Yeah.
What the hell? Everything you're saying, it's just empty promises.
It's true my words would ring hollow if anyone else spoke them.
My name is Byakuya Togami.
But I am Byakuya Togami, and I am destined to bring these promises to fruition.
Yowza, he's so cool!
I agree. I don't want Byakuya to die, though. He's the only one who can, like, bust this thing open. He's the most intelligent character in the game, right now.
Huh. I don't care what you say. I'm just gonna do whatever I feel like. Do what you will. However, remember what I said earlier.
In the name of my family,
I will not let any of you become a victim. That is the duty I have appointed to myself.
It seems like Byakuya resolved it, for now. But even if he's the ultimate Yakuza, there's no way Fuyuhiko really meant what he said earlier. Right? What?
This is troubling!
It looked like you guys were arguing, so I wasn't sure when to actually show up. It looks like I showed up at an awkward time!
Gotta get a drink of water, sorry.
Why are you dressed like that?
Hey!
Oh! Didn't I mention it in my recent broadcast? It's my costume for the fun time!
Oh, don't tell me you're going to.
Correct!
That's right! Since we're on a tropical island, I'm here to do my two-man comedy routine! Why does it matter that we're on a tropical island? But can you do a two-man comedy routine all by yourself?
Of course!
Not! That's why I brought my partner! What is all this?
Meaningless. That figures, brother.
Thank you for waiting.
Now then, without further ado, I'm pleased to present Monokuma's side-splitting live two-man comedy show. Huh? I didn't hear anything about this. Are you telling me I have to improvise?
I'm speechless.
Cutscene? No.
Hello! I'm Monokuma!
I'm Monami!
And together we are the Monokumas! Now, I know it's sudden, but I guess I should show you guys my amazing mind-reading abilities!
Wait, what is that icon on the top left? I'm gonna try and click the... Is it gonna skip it if I do the... What happens if I want to click it? Okay, nothing happens. If I click the right button.
Minds? As practice, I'll guess your favorite food. Your favorite food is...
You can do it. It's obvious what rabbits like.
Cat.
That's right.
Dabbers.
I'd never eat a dead body.
Now then, Monami's up next. Come on, do a short skit or something.
What? There's no way I can do that.
No worries, it's all good. I know a technique to summon the god of comedy. So, which do you think is better? Taking blood while you're still alive or after you're already dead?
Well, oh, it's a laughing button? Oh, you're right, just noticed that. Okay, that's cute, that's a nice addition. Should kill if you don't laugh hard enough. That should be actually, yeah, that should be. It's a nice addition. Props to the devs on that. But what I wanted to say is that obviously, if you're dead, you can't take blood. So.
Why would you ask such a cruel question?
If I'm gonna summon the comma deity, then I'll need a lot of blood.
So a god of comedy wants blood.
Pretty please.
No matter how charmingly you ask, there's no way I'll let you take my blood.
You're always so quick to make a scary face, Monami. You guys better be careful, too. You know, since Monami's actually a bad guy. She's as bad as the first villain the hero fights in a teen manga.
They're always the underdog.
Believe me, it's a fact that Monami's a villain! I'll let you all in on a little secret of hers. Monami went out of her way to erase your memories!
Say what? Wait,
huh? You guys don't even remember how you got to this island, am I right? Well, that's because Monami stole your memories!
What are you saying all of a sudden?
But wait, there's more! She didn't just steal your boring memories, like how you guys got to this island. She completely took away your memories of the years you spent at Hope's Peak Academy! What a shocker!
Interesting. How does that sit on the timeline? I don't get it. Thought on Friends, a TV show? Amazing TV show, what can I say? It's gone kind of stale because of all the reruns. I've seen every episode like 50 times, but there was one time where I somehow managed to, there was a rerun of an episode that I haven't seen before, and I laughed my ass off. It's a really good show that's been destroyed by reruns.
I feel great now that I've shared that with you. Seriously, memory loss plots are so old hat nowadays. Only a total hack would wait until the end of the story to reveal a cliched twist like that!
Please stop!
Wasn't that a huge surprise? In truth, you guys aren't freshman students at all!
I never met anyone who really hates Friends. I mean, I'm probably the only person who doesn't really like it that much, and it's only because I've seen it so many times. Normie sitcoms. Shut up, Simeon. Just because I don't like, I don't know, Caribbean Three's Company doesn't mean that I don't like. Besides, what aren't there, are there like non-normie sitcoms? What's a non-normie sitcom? Like some YouTube edgelord shit?
You guys just thought you were because you've lost all of your school memories. Quick! Someone get a plagiarist, because I feel like I've heard this story before!
Seriously, this is bad in so many ways!
Oh, snap.
I'm through dealing with you!
Ugh, his backhand is far too powerful!
Okay, we're done with that. What, the Big Bang Theory is the normie shit? The Big Bang Theory is really shit. It's really, really bad. But yeah, there's no not, like, a sitcom is by definition normie, because it's a played formula. It's a tried and proven formula that just works on most people. That's the way it just works. Anyhow, you guys haven't seen shit until you've experienced the glories of Salatut El Amat. You're right, I haven't seen Salatut El Amat.
What did he mean?
Hey!
Shit, what do I want to say?
How was it? Was it funny?
Luke claimed that Louie is a normie? Well, Louie isn't a sitcom, though. Anyhow, Louie isn't a sitcom, so, your point is valid.
How was it? Was it funny? Or was the comedy too highbrow for you?
Come on.
Hey, what were you saying just now? You didn't know that?
Huh?
Dick, I haven't seen the Dick Van Dyke Show. Saw some episodes of Lucy and it was nice. It's nice to watch it. That's it. See, Louie isn't a sitcom. It's not. It's a comedy show. But it's not a sitcom by definition.
What was I saying just now? Oh, you mean when I said that your school memories were completely stolen?
Simeon, don't quote me some Wikipedia definition, okay? I fucking learned this shit for 4 years. Louie just isn't a sitcom, and I think most people would agree with me.
Completely stolen? Our school memories completely? What is he saying?
There's no way. Because I just entered Hopespeak Academy, and then I was brought to this island right away.
It's true.
That's because that's how you remember it. All thanks to Monomi stealing your school memories.
What are you saying? That's impossible.
Who knows?
Shit, I'm sorry. I'm getting confused with the talk about sitcoms on chat. I can talk about that later. I'd love to.
Man, how many years has it been since you guys first entered Hopespeak Academy? I wonder what happened to your friends and family. They're probably worried sick about you. Maybe.
Impossible!
Our school memories were stolen? That's ridiculous, brother!
That's right!
That's right! There's no way I have memory loss!
You can't!
Don't listen to what he says! Limit breached!
I won't believe!
I refuse to believe such a thing. Yep, everything's okay. I don't believe it.
Lying, right? Stealing our memories. That's a lie, right? You're just trying to make fools out of us, right?
Wrong.
Nope, it's not a lie. If it was a lie, then how do you explain this? The moment you arrived at Hopespeak Academy, you all had experienced a strange dizziness. What? How do you know that?
Because he did it himself.
Actually, why, that was the cutoff point! Your memories beyond that point have been completely removed!
What the hell? I could feel myself getting lightheaded. I couldn't think. I couldn't speak. I could only breathe. In heavy, gasping breaths.
Oh, in heavy, gasping breaths.
So, a long time has passed since then?
Impossible!
There's no way!
Like...
On the contrary, why is it impossible?
That's...
Whether or not it's possible, there's no way we can't believe it.
No, no!
You just don't want to believe it, right?
Yeah!
But don't worry, I'm a generous guy. I can give you back your memories!
Hey!
However, there's a catch.
Could it be?
Don't tell me the catch is... Figured it out yet?
That's right!
You guys have to kill each other! That's my bargaining point!
Hey!
You guys wanna know, right? You want your school memories returned to you, right? Then you better start killing! A penny for your thoughts, and a murder for your memories!
You pissed me off.
Hey, stop running your mouth.
What?
My, why so angry? I'm just providing you all a motive from the bottom of my big, generous heart. Otherwise, you cowards wouldn't get any killing done. Well, that's not your fault. Humans are natural-born cowards. They even cry after their mom squeezes them out.
Special bleeding service!
I wonder if bears cry when they're born.
That's why I'm giving you a motive. Think of it as an excuse to commit your future crimes.
Quiet.
Stop this at once. Do you really think your delusional ramblings will convince us to commit murder?
What are you saying?
I don't even believe that memory loss crap in the first place.
Girls, don't fight in chat. It's just a stupid fucking show.
But more than that, what you guys really don't believe is each other, right?
What's going on?
What do you mean?
Hey,
you guys don't know each other, which means...
Yaha!
None of you realize that a traitor is hiding among you, right?
Same deal as last time. I bet the traitor is... well, it could be a bunch of people, but the obvious choice would be... Nagito, whatever his name, the lucky student.
Hey, why are there 16 of you? If a total of 15 students from Hope's Peak Academy were arranged to come to this island...
I got it!
That's right! There's probably a traitor I don't even know about hiding among the group! Just kidding!
You...
What are you saying? All this shit about traitors doesn't make any sense!
It's obviously nonsense.
Lame!
For real, you guys! How can you be so sure? You guys don't know anything about each other! You don't know each other's true natures! That's why, if one of you is planning to kill someone, it's impossible for any of you to know!
With those words, everyone fell silent. I wanted someone to argue with, anybody. But nobody said a word. They just stood there.
Uh-huh.
Even so, if there really is a traitor, isn't that gosh darn awful? Pretending to be your ally and tricking you guys. It makes sense for someone like that to get killed, right? Come on! Make the preemptive strike! It's first come, first serve, and the winner takes all! If you want to survive, you gotta find that person before they find you!
Even after Monokuma's boisterous laughter faded away, we all just stood there. Every one of us. This situation, this circumstance, this phenomenon, this disaster, this nightmare, this hell, this despair. It consumed every one of us.
Is it true? Is there really a traitor among us?
You've got it wrong!
It's not me, by the way. I know I may look suspicious, but it's not me.
Who is it? Hurry up and show yourself. You're only making things worse for you by staying silent, brother.
That's enough.
Just stop. There's no way there's a traitor. There's no way. It's pointless to even discuss something so foolish.
I won't believe.
That's right. I don't believe it. Because there's no way I can believe it. There's no reason in the first place to believe it. Manomi, you would know. Is what Monokuma said true about our memory loss and about the traitor?
Everyone needs to look to the future. That's why you shouldn't look back to the past. Keep your eyes fixed upon the future. Let's do our very best.
Huh?
She ran away.
How ridiculous. Memory loss, a traitor. It's completely fictional.
Dumbass.
I can't deal with this bullshit, dumbass.
As he said, it's a work of fiction. It's entirely different from the reality I know. Stolen memories? All of my school memories? Everything? A traitor hiding among us?
It's not a female bear, Mori. She's a female rabbit.
But what really struck me was when Monokuma said, "You guys don't know anything about each other."
Well, if they've been together for years, then obviously they do know. They just forgot it. And there's no reason they shouldn't trust each other. I wonder why no one says that. Because they're all idiots.
Ahem! Hope's Peak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make! It is now 10 p.m. Please return to your rooms and relax. Let the sound of the ocean gently rock you to sleep. Now then, sweet dreams, everyone! Good night!
Well, whatever. We might get lucky and get a murder before the end of the stream.
Hey.
What should we do?
It's better if we call it a night here. Some Shiru level shit? What does that mean, Simeon? I don't get that reference. We should get some sleep and try to keep our minds calm.
Oh.
I guess you're right.
This is your leader's order.
Just so you all know, do not think about unnecessary things. This is your leader's order. Tomorrow morning, let's meet at the restaurant after Monokuma's morning announcement.
How troubling. I think the saying goes, I am frightened so stiff.
Huh?
Oh, that. Killing someone to death, you mean? I see.
I feel pretty stiff right now, too. That's not how the saying goes. But it's not her fault. She's a foreigner, after all.
Whatever. Hope someone dies already.
To be honest, I don't really remember what happened after that. But later, I realized something. I was sitting on my bed beside the cottage, with my head drooping down to my chest. As I sat there alone, a strange thought suddenly crossed my mind. Traitor. Could it be someone who isn't like the others? Like someone who doesn't even remember what their talent is?
What are you that? Oh, you think someone would suspect you?
What the hell? I don't understand at all. I put these stupid thoughts out of my mind and collapsed onto my bed. Immediately, I closed my eyes.
No one died yet, Gecko. Maybe someone will die tonight and we'll find out in the morning. We'll see. I hope we'll find out before the stream is over.
Closing my eyes was the only thing I could do to escape from this otherworldly reality.
What?
They say, impossible is a word that's only found in a fool's dictionary. Obviously, it's impossible to use a word that's not in your dictionary. If someone can actually make the impossible possible...
It's all over if you say that!
You can truly call that person someone who doesn't have the impossible!
Whatever. What are you talking about, guests? I'm not following your... what you're saying.
Ahem! Hope's Peak Academy School Trip Executive Committee has an announcement to make! Good morning, everyone! Looks like today is gonna be another perfect tropical day! Now then, let's show some enthusiasm and make sure to give it our all today!
I slowly and awkwardly sat up in my bed.
But I can't believe it's been like two fucking nights and no one's dead yet.
Both my head and my body felt heavy, but it was still an improvement compared to last night. We all said we'd meet at the restaurant.
Let's check on my pet real quick. Snake is all good. That's great. Let's leave. What's up, dude? I hate you.
Not everyone is as strong as Byakuya. I've never thought about having to overcome anything before. It's not like I just run away from my problems, but it's more like I was just living my life without even thinking about them at all. Even so, I was still able to live, but this is different. I'm sorry, I was being too negative. No, I understand, I'm the same as well. But now that we've talked, I feel assured once again. Fuck you. Being loners won't get us anywhere. That's why I think we should all help each other out.
Obviously, they knew that all the pesky action from the Danganronpa needed to be replaced with all this wonderful exposition. Yep, definitely.
Also, I think we need to get stronger. An ordeal like this is what will make us cling to hope. Yeah, you're probably right.
Bye now.
Well, I'll be heading to the restaurant now.
Okay. Do whatever you want, dude. I feel like I need to talk to them, even though I probably don't.
Hey. Good morning, Hajime.
Yeah, good morning.
Aww.
Jeez, what's with a sullen face?
Hmm.
Well, I guess I'm not one to talk. I couldn't really sleep last night. I had a lot on my mind, and I don't know if I'll ever get the answers I'm looking
Aww.
For. Man, just for kicks, I should prepare some yummy desserts and tea and invite some people to come chat with
that
me.
It?
Ah, just so you know, it's gonna be a girls-only gathering. Don't expect the boys to be invited.
Sounds like an excuse for some girl talk. What do girls even talk about? I guess guys will never know.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll go on ahead. You better hurry and go to the restaurant.
Whatever.
Jeez!
I'm so sleepy! Mr. Hamhands is so selfish. It's only fine to spend the morning sleeping in.
But if we need to eat breakfast anyway, what's wrong with eating it together?
Aww.
Well, I'd like to spend my breakfast eating sweets in my room. That's already fine.
Eating sweets for breakfast is bad for your health. You're consuming too many sugars and fats.
Hey!
Who made you my doctor? Don't speak to me without my permission.
She said,
"Jeez, listening to this ugly bitch's crying in the morning makes me so sick."
Kyoko, you definitely have an ultimate bad attitude.
Nice one.
Hello.
Good morning.
Yeah, good morning. What is it? I just said good morning. Why is she so shocked?
My first time greeting someone, and I was actually greeted back. I'm so happy. Could you do it one more time?
Hello?
Good morning.
Good morning. What kind of life has she had?
Aren't you going or something? Whatever. Check out the bed one more time. No poopies. Awesome. Obviously not everyone's here.
Several people were already at the restaurant. But nobody was talking, not a single word. While they sat there, the people who were late began to arrive as well.
Oh, okay.
I've made you wait.
Is everyone here?
Huh?
It seems Fuyuhiko is not here yet. Maybe he already got killed. Dead bodies already?
No.
Don't go killing people off. I saw him outside earlier. However, told me he would not be joining us this morning.
Oh, so he's basically this game's Byakuya this time.
Why does he have to act like a lone wolf at a time like this?
Maybe.
Could he? Is he thinking up a plan to kill someone by himself?
You must not!
Kazuichi, you should not doubt your friend.
Hey!
Well, he's a Yakuza, isn't he? Do you understand what that means? He's part of the Japanese Mafia! I presume he's the kind of person who would not come even if we summoned him.
That's fine.
I guess it can't be helped. We should just talk amongst ourselves. Someone can fill him in later.
Talk? What are we going to talk about?
Rejoice.
I have decided to throw a party tonight.
Huh?
Party?
That's right.
A huge party that will last from sundown to sunrise.
What the?
Party till the sun comes up?
This is your leader's order.
Just so we're clear, I will not allow any absences. Your attendance at this party is absolutely mandatory.
Huh?
Hey, now is not the time to talk about stuff like partying. On the contrary, there is no better time than this.
But still, we really shouldn't be partying.
Wait!
Hold on. I agree with Byakuya. It doesn't do us any good to stay bummed out like this.
Hey.
In fact, because of the situation we're in, it's probably best if we all strengthen our friendships with one another. That's what you thought too, right? That's why you wanted to throw a party.
It doesn't matter why I'm doing it. Anyway, it is of vital importance that we all stay in one place tonight.
You fiend.
You say that with such significance.
It's all clear now.
It's decided. We're having ourselves a party.
But even so, I'm not sure it needs to last all night.
Stop talking.
If I thought that, I would have made that clear from the beginning.
I'm sorry.
I'm terribly sorry. I'm so sorry. So sorry for trying to meddle with your plan.
I see. It's important to be flexible in situations like this, brother. Perhaps a diversion from all this is just what we need.
Yahoo!
Then let's party hard.
In that case, I'll put my amazing cooking skills on display for you guys.
Where's the party going to be held? Would this restaurant be okay?
No, this won't do. We need a location that's impervious to interference from outsiders. A place even Monokuma cannot enter. What we need is an enclosed space.
An enclosed space?
How beautiful.
If the restaurant won't do, then neither will the lobby. That's not nearly enclosed enough.
Nor will the cottages. With so many people, we would all be pressed up against each other. But if you want to be pressed up against each other, then a cottage is clearly the best choice.
I can't stop drooling.
Pressing up against ladies without sneaking aboard the women-only train and drag, I feel so lucky.
There's something wrong with you.
I can't believe how comforting you are with saying your perverted thoughts out loud.
I may be a pervert, but I'm the kind of pervert everybody likes.
Your confidence is seriously impressive.
Hey.
Then, how about that old-looking building near this hotel?
Huh?
That rundown place?
You're right.
Yeah, but if we do our best to clean it, I think it'd be perfect. Plus, it's basically the only place that meets our needs for an enclosed space, right?
However.
Indeed. However, Monomi has forbidden us from entering that old place. As I recall, it's in the middle of being renovated.
I have heard your conversation! Heard it all with my very own ears! I have good ears, cause I'm a rabbit!
I see.
Oh, so you use your ears. That's strange. Then what is the reason for those surveillance cameras? Are they for Monokuma's eyes only? No, they're for the audience. Come on, dude, you're supposed to know this.
Hello!
She looks so disappointed!
That's fine.
Well, it is of no concern. We can settle that issue another time.
Listen.
A diaper, Simeon. She's wearing a diaper. Regarding the old building, you came to tell us something about it, right?
Yes! If it strengthens everyone's bonds with each other, then I will not hesitate to cooperate.
I shall allow it.
So in that case, I will allow you to enter the old building. I'll cooperate so we can all party together.
Together? That's not gonna happen because you're so disgusting.
Understand?
Do yourself a favor and stay away from mirrors. You'll be grossed out by what you see.
Your kind words make me want to cry.
So we're all good with the old building?
And?
Then what about the preparations? If it's in the middle of a renovation, don't we need to clean it first? I have never done the dirty work known as cleaning before. I am excited to finally experience it.
Hey, hey, hey!
No way! There's no way we can dirty our dude princess's hands!
Aww.
Yeah, I don't want to do it either!
Jeez! What? Nobody's going to do it?
In that case, why don't we decide by a random drawing?
Actually...
To be honest, I already prepared a drawing because I assumed something like this would happen.
Dude, you're such a traitor.
To go to the trouble of preparing this? Just what did you think would happen?
See?
Whoever draws the chopsticks with a red mark on it will be in charge of cleaning, okay? Does that sound fair?
Judgment!
Well then, let us entrust our destinies to the whims of this drawing.
All right.
Well, no hard feelings. One by one, everybody took turns pulling the chopsticks Nagito held in his hand.
No, no one still died, Gecko. I'm assuming the guy who is going to draw the short straw now is going to be the guy who will be alone cleaning, and then he'll die. That's what I'm assuming will happen, but it'll only happen next stream.
And when it was all said and done...
What?
Huh? I am left with a red mark?
Oh, thank God he's going to die.
For someone called the ultimate lucky student, you don't seem very lucky right now.
Wow.
I guess it can't be helped.
Alright!
Well, if it's just cleaning, leave it to me. I'm actually pretty good at it. I thought so. You seem like you'd make a good stay-at-home dad. I'll take that as a compliment.
Okay!
I'll handle the cooking. Alright, first I need to prepare my ingredients. Then I'll start cooking at the old building.
There's no mistaking it.
I, Teru Teru Hanamura, will go all out. I will prepare the world's tastiest dishes for you all.
Then
I just need to pass along the party details to Fuyuhiko.
Let's go about our business then. After Monokuma's nightly announcement, we'll meet at the old building.
After everyone left, I decided to go back to the cottage. There's still some time before the party. There's no way I can spend it staring into space in my room. Well, since I have some free time, it'd be better if I went and talked to everyone.
And free time, our favorite time. Okay, so I'm gonna save right now. It's actually past the end time for my stream. So thanks everybody for sticking around. I'll be back probably on Sunday. Stay tuned to the schedule to make sure. I'll update it probably tomorrow night when I'll know for sure. But I'll probably be available on Sunday stream. And I remind you guys about the requested games poll. You can feel free to request games over there or vote for games that are already that have already been requested. So I'll pick sooner rather than later. And what else? And if you guys want, you can always follow me using Twitch, Twitter, Steam, or YouTube. And that way you can watch my past broadcasts if you miss them or miss some of them. And you can get updates if I'm canceling a stream, if I'm doing a surprise stream like I did today earlier before this stream. Or if there's any change at all in the schedule, I'll always update there. And that's it for now. So thanks everybody for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed yourselves. I'm having a nice time with this game. I can't wait for the murders to actually start happening so we can really have fun. And that's it. See you guys later. Marco.